FM News. On point. News on XFM, I'm Chris Tim. The Speaker of the Ugandan Parliament has asked members of Parliament who have a list of missing people to bring them to the House so that they can task government to account for their whereabouts. Last week, Parliament directed the Minister of Internal Affairs to table a list of all missing persons under the custody of the security after the Kawempe North MP. Latif Sebagala noted that even though the President had directed security agencies to release the list, up to now, they are yet to respond. The matter of failure to release the list was brought forward by the Kalungu West Member of Parliament, Joseph Sewungu, who noted that since the minister has failed to bring the list, he should be allowed to bring a list of the people who are missing.
So, Madam Speaker, as I conclude, I am saying that if the minister is not ready to produce the list, I am ready, as I've always done, to bring the names of those people. And where they are.
Sewungu's plea was supported by several members of parliament who noted that it's important for people to know the whereabouts of the missing people, which prompted the speaker to allow MPs who have any lists of missing people to bring them to parliament and ask government to account for their whereabouts.
When we last sat last week, we asked the Minister of Internal Affairs to bring the list, both from the UPDF and from the Uganda Police Force, laid on the table. But in the absence of that, I want to ask those members who have missing people to produce a list, present it here, then we ask the government to account for those people. I think that's what we can do at this stage.
The Koboko County Member of Parliament, Margaret Babadiri, is concerned over the continued absence of the Deputy Speaker, Jacob Olanya, from Parliament. This was after several members of Parliament offered their condolences to the Speaker after the passing on of her daughter, Sheila Alitwala. Babadiri, while raising the matter of national importance, noted that the Speaker should be at home, and it's times like this that the Deputy Speaker should come in to assist her in fulfilling the speakership roles. The Speaker, in response, informed the MPs that they will see the Deputy Speaker when he comes.
Madam Speaker, you have a Deputy Speaker who should help you when you are busy, when you're in a problem. I'd like to find out what has happened to the Deputy Speaker. For long, I've not seen him. Is he on leave? Where is he? So that he can help you at this difficult moment. Thank you very much, Madam Speaker. You will see him.
Mothers have been cautioned to stop the habit of denying fathers access to their children in case of family breakups, an act that is contrary to the children's law. The appeal has been made by the State Minister for Youth and Children Affairs, Florence Nachiwala Chiinji, during the launch of the Children's Clinic at the National Children's Authority headquarters in Ntinda. The minister cited Article 59, Subsection 4 of the Constitution that gives both parents the right to access their children even after separation.
Article 59, subsection 4 states that the two parents have a right to children. Where there is a separation, the children must still access their parents, because this is the right given to them through the Constitution, that they have a right to information, that is the right to know your father and mother and to love them. It's not about money, it's not about houses and property, but it's about physical presence and the character. So now we have decided that according to that section, that the father should have access to one of the children.
Meanwhile, the executive director, the National Children's Authority, Martin Kiza, asked couples with problems to report them to the authority for mitigation so as to save the children from all sorts of abuses.
We are here ready to ensure that we mitigate and reduce on cases that affect our children, that also possibly affect the parents. But the point here is that we are not making any judgments. We are making referrals, and we are urging the community there. If you have any cases pending, please, you must first report the Office of the Minister of State.
The National Water and Sewerage Corporation has offered a six-month amnesty campaign for its disconnected customers across the country to get reconnected. The corporation expects to reconnect over 100,000 customers to get back on the supply through this campaign. Mahmoud Lutaya, the National Water and Sewerage Corporation director in Kampala District, says that they are targeting clients disconnected due to non-payment and illegal use of water.
We believe, and it is, we are convinced that most of these customers still need our water. But for one reason or another, they are off supply. One of the reasons for which they may be off supply is they have accumulated a high stock of arrears that they are unable to pay, and they have been disconnected. And maybe they have not been able to pay this money. The other reason could be some of them could have encountered the leakages after the meter, and the bills arising out of those leakages have been too high for them, and as a result they have been disconnected.
He said the campaign benefits include waiving reconnection fees, free meters and flexible arrears payment options as deemed by the customers. In world news, Texas will lift its mask requirement and allow businesses to reopen at full capacity next week, Governor Craig Abbott has announced. It is now time to open Texas 100%, the Republican said on Tuesday. Texas is the largest U.S. state to end its mask mandate. Mr. Abbott has faced criticism from his party over the measure, which was imposed last July. But the administration of U.S. President Joe Biden has made it clear coronavirus restrictions are still necessary. The announcement in Texas came as similar rules were lifted in other states, including Michigan, Louisiana, and Mississippi. In the South, which also ended its mask mandate. The rollout of vaccinations against COVID-19 has boosted confidence in a return to pre-pandemic life in the United States. In sports, Pep Guardiola believes Manchester City have come through hell and done something more than remarkable by overcoming a tough winter schedule to extend their winning run to 21 games in all competitions by beating Wolverhampton Wanderers in a Premier League game played last night. Their 4-1 victory, courtesy of three goals inside the final 10 minutes, means City have not dropped points in the league since drawing with West Bromwich Albion on the 15th of December and are now 15 points clear at the top of the table. During that time, they have played 21 games in all competitions, reached the final of the League Cup at the quarterfinals of the FA Cup and taken control of their last 16 Champions League tie against the German outfit Borussia Mönchengladbach. And that's the latest XFM news. XFM news on point.